We go back at it, about six of the evening. Power play 39 live from the Melbourne Pavilion in Flemington. We got a cracker here, Dwayne. Tanner Gulmastis versus Dean Vujic. What do you think?
Look, both fighters, again, a good amount of fight experience behind them, not much in height difference, similar age, different states. New South Wales, Victoria always seems to bring a bit of blood with it.
Yeah, look, both young guys, both pretty well experienced. Both very good win ratios. Again, going to come down here for me to game plan, because pretty similar match guys, so let's see who brings a more strategic approach to this fight.
I can tell you one thing for the audience, we're going to see a slightly higher weight division than we've seen tonight so far, with full tie rules. So I'd expect a lot of power behind the shots, a lot of movement, and the clinch to be in a very aggressive part of the game.
And he's a
Power play 31.
Got some experience fighting on power play, which is always handy. Also a training partner of Quan Trinh at 8 Blades, so you know, these guys get incredibly well trained. We've seen 8 Blades in action just earlier tonight. So again, for me it's like, let's see, Superboy's going to have a great game plan, we always know that. We know that Tanner's going to come prepared, and a very good knockout ratio. 60% of his fights he wins by stoppage. So he's, you know, he's going to be looking for the finish, which means aggression's going to be there. The power in his hands, we already know. It's too tough, like these fights tonight, like all good match fights should be. So credit to Joe Nader putting together fights that just too close to call.
Yeah, I have to say, over a 50% knockout ratio out of your wins is, your overall fights, and out of 10 wins, 60% of your fights have come by knockout. That's an amazing amount of power to be fitted in Tanner's hands.
Well, you know what you're going to get, and then same for Dean. Now, Dean's a bit more strategic, a bit more technical. He's gone the distance in a lot more of his fights. So it might be weathering the storm early on here. Tanner's going to come out all guns blazing.
Just to be clear, we're K1 rules here in this one.
little bit of misunderstanding here. They're under the K1 fight. That looks big, yeah. That's 5 centimetres, but not quite. Company bred you come with that, but just looks more rangy again. So how do you manipulate your game plan then if you're Tanner?
I think Tanner, no matter what reach management I have, this is you might want to keep away.
He's going to come out and throw, watch his leg straight away.
Tanner looks to be a lot more kettle, mate. He's just boiling and ready to go.
There you go, bang, bang. Oh, big right hand. That's what we spoke about. Deans has got to, you know, harbour the early enthusiasm from Tanner. Deans is waiting to the fight.
Look for Tanner to close up the gap with that jab and lean in on it.
Nice high guard from Deans. And again, just settle a little bit. Deans is waiting for the fight. Got to check those kicks. Look at that one kick. Look at the reds. Oh, the legs. Tanner looks really light on his feet, doesn't he?
Absolutely.
Really agile, using his ankle as well.
I don't want to get too stationary. He's on the right, Tanner's got cut ankles and keep moving.
Pretty much when I said he used his ankle as well, he stopped, so never the chance. Right left, body shot, I like it. Only one, he'll back it off. No flinches, no holding like the neck in the K1. Inside leg kick was nice, it's aiming for the rose and the styrene. Target there. Body kick. Dean's got to start throwing, he's barely throwing it.
Very composed, and I think he's looking for his own kicks. I do agree, this is
really. But at the same time, you've got to give your opponent something to be afraid of, something to be preparing for.
That. A couple of times, like, give him two times to get the gas, and then there's no chance to count.
That's right. I do like the guard. The guard's really high. Using the front kick to maintain distance. And again, Tanner's nowhere near that. That missed by 30 centimetres out. That was a bit closer.
I'd like to see Dean use his high leverage better.
Oh, don't leave the jab out there a little bit. Leave the jab out. Use the thrust kick. Oh, good slip though. Just evaded. Oh!
Top wind of that overhead rod.
That was a massive shot. Oh, good left hand.
Nice body work there.
Following him up. Oh, way perfect meet. Throws it the way up. Fake in a left body shot, but perfectly blocked by Dean. Trouble. Catch him first row there. I've seen this a number of times tonight where one comes out as the aggressor, Tanner this time, and then the opponent just eases their way in. Dean went through.
So on the field again, and you need a pretty way to get to the box first.
So on the field that first round though, the boys both sort of planted feet and were just waiting for the opportunity. It's like watching, you know, two kettles, you're wondering which one's going to overwhelm first. And I think in the second round we'll see which one's going to move up.
Though. Oh, good left kick. Isaac's kick. That right hand got through. That's the last one for sure. That's been pretty fair here.
Yeah, Dean is absolutely just doing something to stop Tanner when he comes in and plays all that power.
Use a jab, use a kick then. Keep with this. Oh! The Mark Tyson left. Whole body went into it. Now they're swinging. They are swinging like Dunny Dawes here. Got a fire
right
back, Dean.
Got to throw.
Dean's got to go. Oh, he wants the knees. Again. He's hurt the body of Tanner. The massive targets the body of Tanner.
On the legs of Dean, there's some damage. We saw him realize it. It's weird, I didn't think I'd say this, but I think it's going to be a match with suit Dean.
True.
The challenge for Dean is that first minute with Tanner is so dangerous that you really don't want to just be sitting there weathering it, both from a points point of view and from a point of view of his head, the weight that he has in his hands and his legs.
This could legitimately be a round each for two rounds to none for each of the opponents. It's been that close.
Absolutely.
There is a cut on the right eyelid though with Tanner, so that's what I'm going for. That left jab, keep it there. Okay, good left. Again, same Tanner coming out aggressive.
Oh, nice right hand from Tanner.
Dean's got some whiskers, I tell you. Gotta go to the corner.
Legs.
Oh, to go.
Connor and Dean told him to keep his chin down. He knows that Tanner's going to throw. And it's a dangerous moment for Dean. He can attack, but he also be attacked.
This is what Tanner's game plan is. Keep him away from me. Oh, he's connected. Oh, again. Gee, Dean's eating some punches in this fight.
The corner of Dean, I yell at him. No one Tanner can do.
Tanner's still going to have some cobwebs there. He took a massive shot, so he's going to find his range.
You could think you've got it done at that point. How many fighters have we seen get knocked out?
Oh, when they run back in there. Oh, that's the one.
That's more
hurt him again.
There.
Hurt him again. There was, got to go. Oh, can't do that. We're not far away from this. Not far away from an announcement here. How big an issue is that point deduction to be here, Dwayne?
We saw it. It's one fight. I mean, you and I in our own commentary were talking about one fighter taking charge of strike and calling on the other fighter. I almost, it's hard for me that third round. We both saw Tanner get knocked down. We'll have it count at least. And then a point taken away from Lee. I don't think it even sums out. I think that point's going to be in this fight.
It'd be a real shame. And I think I've called for like 5 rematches tonight already. But even before I hear the decision, that's worthy of a rematch. Because that was entertaining, man.
Just a fight card, power play 40, the same as 39. Just rematch them.
Except for Kimlin and Bottichino, because that one's sort of defining. Albeit they're now 1-1, so that has to be a rematch. Just do it again. Let's come back next Saturday night and go again. Good fight, though. Real good fight. Both boys put it all on the line. And again, it's unfortunately decided, but like you said, he had heaps of warnings, or at least 5 warnings for holding the back of the head. K1 fight. So it's taking some time here, and that always worries me. There's time to calculate.
Absolutely. We've got to think either fighter wanted to leave it in the hands of the judges.
Give it a draw. They'll come back again. We'll do it in the cage on December 8th.
They both tried to do what they could to leave to take this out of the hands of the judges, but both fighters had to snap it out to go through, and we're going to see what happens.
Perry Kale's pacing here, so we won't be far away from his decision. I'm going to draw. He's going to put it out there. No, it's a draw.
I think a draw?
Majority draw will go.
I think the point's going to hurt Dean too much.
When they're describing it like that, it's a complicated one.
I think that point's going to hurt Dean.
Here we go, center ring, Perry Kale, official decision.
All right, we've got to go. This is Rick McMillan and Sybil. Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard. Before we do, a big round of applause to both fighters for a fantastic contest. After 3 rounds of action, once again, we go to the scorecard. It is a split decision. Mark, 28-27, Rick McMillan. 28-27, 28-27,
Benjamin Connor. 28-27 for your winner by split decision. Benjamin Connor.